Awesome, let's take a look at how to install Node.js on our system and how to make sure that it's working and how to do like a simple example with the interactive console. Okay, so in Windows, it's dead easy. So you basically go to nodejs.org and then you will be prompted with this landing page. And this is how you download Node.js for Windows. If you don't know what you're doing, or if you're not an advanced user, or you don't want the latest feature, I very strongly recommend you stick to the LTS, so the more stable release, like this one. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to just double click one here. I'm going to save this file somewhere on my desktop. Okay, and then that's going to download, and it's going to take a couple seconds here, and then I just downloaded the installer. What I'm going to do now is I'm just going to double click on the installer. This window is going to pop up, and then I'm going to say yes. Let's do this. It's taking a little bit. Yes, so we want to install. I accept the terms of agreement. Let's do it here. And then this is the part that I wanted to cover. So we're going to start. We're going to install everything. We're going to install the packet manager, NPM. I don't care whether if you do online documentation or not, but this is very important. We need to add Node.js to the path. What that means is that Node.js will change the standard path in our Windows and will add a link to where Node.js lives on our system. This is important because we want our system to know where Node.js lives so that we can use it from any folder or from anywhere in our computer. I'll show you what that means in a second. So I'm going to go yes, and then some NPM modules need to be compiled from C++, whatever. So this one, depending on how much you have coded or not, you may have these tools already or not. So I'm going to recommend in your case that you do install the necessary tools, even though I'm not going to do it because I have a lot of stuff going on in my computer already. So I'm going to recommend that you actually do this. And then we're going to install this, space requirements, it's going to do its thing, blah, blah, blah. Okay. All right, removing files, etc. And then something that I'm going to do in the meantime, I'm going to open an Explorer window, and I'm going to show you where that path that we were referring to lives. So for example, if I right click on my PC and I click on properties, you can see that if I go to advanced system settings and I go to environment variables, you can see that there's this thing called the path here. If I double click on the path, this is a list of all the programs that are publicly accessible in my computer and that I can access from anywhere in any terminal. You can see that Node.js has itself added as part of the path. So this is good. And that's what we want. And you can see that here, the Node.js has finished installing. So we're good, etc. And then let's see if that worked. Okay. The way we're going to do that is we're going to open a terminal, a command prompt in our Windows machine. I'm going to be doing these tutorials for Windows. I don't have a Mac, I'm sorry, but it's not very difficult to do it in Mac either. And the way I'm going to do this is I'm going to do Windows search, and then you can see it is on my other screen, but this search window pops up, and I'm going to type CMD or command prompt. And as I do that, this thing shows up here. This is my command prompt, and I'm going to make the text a little larger so that we can all see better, right? As we do that, you can see that I am now on my system and I'm in this folder, users.jlx. The way to check if Node.js is here or not is by typing node. And then, for example, we're going to ask which version have we installed. So I'm going to do hyphen, and I'm going to type a V. And if I do that, you can see that right now I am running version 14.15.5, which it is exactly what I just installed. Okay, so that is good. That means that Node is running on our system. And as I said, Node is a runtime, which means that it can execute JavaScript scripts, but it can also work as a REPL, which I forget what REPL stands for. Read, evaluate, and print loop. What that means is that we can open an interactive Node session. If I type Node, we enter this interactive session where I can write native JavaScript code. So for example, let's say I'm going to declare a variable called sum that I'm going to say it's going to be 10 plus 23. All right. And then if I now console log the value of sum, I get the value of 33. So, and then here I could just declare a function, something, something. Function, for example, sum A and B is going to be equal to return A plus B. Okay. And then I just, because I can't do that because I already have a variable called sum. So for example, I'm going to call this add. All right. So now I have a function called add, and I can say sum is going to be equal to the addition of 26 and 78. And now I get that console log, the value of sum has now changed to 104. All right. So I have this interactive console that I can use to type JavaScript code, to execute JavaScript code, and to try things out. This is good for beginners, for learning, etc., but it's typically not how we will use Node. We will use Node. I'm going to press Control C two times so that I leave that interactive REPL. The typical way we will do, we will execute Node is by saying, by using Node to run a different JavaScript file. So for example, test file.js, this does not exist on my computer yet, and then it will tell me like, oh, I cannot find this thing, etc., because it's not there. But this is the typical way we will use Node to run JavaScript scripts, very similar to how we typically do Python and then something.py, and then we execute a Python script, right? It's very similar. So, all right. So now that we know, now that we have Node on our system and we know that it's working, how about we start creating our first Node application, which is going to be a simple WebSocket server. So before we do that, let me show you the best way that I think it is to start a simple Node application. Let's take a look at that on the next video.